first year as a head coach at Mizzou. 8 wins, 4 losses, and they capped the season with a 20-15 win over LSU in the Liberty Bowl. They've gotten off to a quick start this year with back-to-back wins over San Diego State and Illinois, and they are led by a fine junior quarterback, Phil Rattler.
He was the catalyst in last year's turnaround, 8-4 season. He was a premier quarterback at the Big 8 Conference, and I certainly believe he is this year. Total offensive leader last year, 189 yards, a 50% passer, and what he does best is come on the corners and turn upfield. He puts a lot of pressure because he can run, he's fast, he's strong, and only 170 pounds, he's very durable.
He's strong for what is the run, and this year he's been passing when he passed to his backs more often than not.
And the reason is, last year they lost 3 of their top receivers, 1 an All-American Kevin Winslow, and this year he's having to go to his backs. Different people, Bob Meyer there, and this man, Jerry Ellis.
Jerry Ellis has caught a couple of passes. Here's one, for example, last week.
He is a big back, 6'2", 220 from Columbia. He had a great game last year against Mississippi, 111 yards. He can catch the football, and of course, when he catches the ball out of the backfield, it puts a lot of pressure on the perimeter, the linebackers, and the people that have to cover.
Steve, it was not thought originally that he would be the starting tailback for Mizzou, but he's come on with a sensational start in 1979.
Well, he's had to. They've had some injury problems with him. Young men will talk about in a minute, but he has come in. He's played quite well, 210 yards, 3 TDs, and also he's caught one. So he's an outstanding player and really gives them a balanced attack in the backfield.
Here he is on the pitch from Bill Bradley going in. Now, the man that was supposed to be the starter should be back today, James Wilder, who is a real horse.
This guy's dying to play. He hasn't played any this season. He had a hamstring problem. This is what he did to people last year. Runs over and through. He's an unbelievable talent. Strong, big, typical of Missouri, a strong back.
In the defensive secondary, the leader there, Eric Wright.
He's picked off 3 of the 7 interceptions this football team's had this year. He's the fastest of the defensive backs. 4-5 speed, not bad for a little run. He's an unbelievable player.
Mizzou runs a 5-2 defense, and at right defensive end, this young man, Wendell Ray.
They say he's the best. Coach Powers says he's the best he's ever been around. He's been a good defensive end. He's fierce, force, and big. You know, he just knocks people down and really demolishes.
And the nose guard, hat and all, Norman Goodman.
They say he's from Superman's fictitious hometown. He's an outstanding player, a very good lateral movement, great player.
That's a quick look at the Mizzou Tigers, 2-0 coming into the game. We'll be back live in Jackson, Mississippi with a look at all the crowd of 46,000 flag-waving fans. Today's pregame show was produced by Bob Goodrich and Dick Buffington, directed by Jim Tenet, technical director Bob Perryberry, the associate director Ken Wolf. Stay tuned next as the Ole Miss Rebels host the ninth-ranked Missouri Tigers on NCAA College Football.
Sunday, Mark can't get Mindy to kiss and make up.
There's a football game tonight at 6:30.
one. And a power set this time. Now Freddie Williams race goes wide right, and Billy Wise, the tight end, sets up tight to the right side. Option play. 4K still has it. He's also got the first down plus five. Mr. Smith comes back in here looking at the Ole Miss offensive level. Last week, 373 yards on the ground, only 35 passing. They were 3 of 12 combined between Coleman and Forcade in that 38-34 victory over Memphis State. Freddie Williams breaks out, and Bill Wise comes to the right side this time. Second down and nine. The option play, the hit goes to Cooper Kupila, and he keeps jumping and working, and he's down to 43-yard line. It was Perry again, a workhorse, and then his jersey torn. And he picks up about seven, it'll be third down and one. There's Forcade on the near side. And our report from the bench is he just had the wind knocked out of him. He broke one back in. Let's see his phone standing with him on his sideline. Third and long one for Ole Miss. An impressive early inning drive now with 9 minutes to go in the first quarter and no score. And Kenny Hooper is the new running back, number 38, and he made the tackle, or rather made the pickup. Lester Dickey made the tackle. And they may have to measure again. No, it's fourth down. They did not pick up the first down. Fourth and one. And Roy Coleman signals that he wants a timeout to throw it up with Steve Sloan. The ball was at the 43. So time has been called to make a decision. Steve Sloan and Roy Coleman on the sideline. We have no score.
135-millimeter reflex.
Hi, I'm Christy Jenner. I just focused and touched this electronic button to give me great pictures automatically.
The XT loads easily too. This signal shows that the film is loaded properly, and the electronic self-timer lets us get into our own pictures. Mills XG1, your automatic choice for action photography.
On ABC's Wide World of Sports, buckets of fun as firemen test their...
Yes, the long return man laying on the 1 yard line, the kid from Jeff Rockhouse. Ball is at the 39 yard line. First down, 10, Mississippi. They lead it 7-3. Allows backfield. Now Freddie Williams breaks out of the backfield, comes in motion left side. There's a flip out here. Wide left. Draw play. Second down, 5.